someone screaming.
You said, I'm not screaming. I have a loud
you
voice.
Are. Louder again. Oh my God, my ears
no,
are hurting.
No, I'm not.
Bring it down. You are.
Your white fragility is killing me right now.
I have a hearing problem.
Don't go after her race. We don't go after your race. Why are you getting so angry? Why are you yelling?
So now I'm the angry black woman.
Why are you so angry? You're an angry woman right now.
All right, reality TV just got realer. In an effort to ramp up diversity, Bravo's signature franchise, The Real Housewives, introduced the first black woman to the New York City cast. Enter Ebony K. Williams, an accomplished lawyer and journalist. Filming for the show's 13th season began shortly after the protests of last summer. And as the racial reckoning swept the nation, fans of the show watched a group of upper-class white women reckon with race on a personal level, likely for the first time in their lives. Joining me now is my friend Ebony K. Williams, host and executive producer of Holding Court with Ebony K. Williams and, as you just saw, a Real Housewife of New York City. Ebony, I'm so happy to have you here. Thank you for joining us. So you and I talked yesterday. We met when you were an anchor at Fox. You were always so supportive. Thank you. We talked yesterday about your role on this show, and I have to tell you, I binge-watched a few episodes. It's a lot. What has your experience been like?
Oh, Tiffany, so great to be with you, my sister, and I appreciate you and so proud of your platform. The experience has been as challenging as any of my career, right? And I say that as you just graciously introduced me, a former host at Fox News. I've been a correspondent at CBS News. I've worked as a trial attorney in criminal defense work and some other things in my career. And this experience as a Real Housewives of New York has been as challenging, but I gotta also tell you, Tiffany, it has been as impactful, probably even in many ways more impactful than any of the work I've been able to be blessed and privileged to do.
So I watched the Harlem episode, and yes. I mean, it was, I couldn't look away. I mean, I will say that. I'm curious if you think, because some of the women say things, and I wonder, does it come from a place of ignorance? Like, you're saying this because you really don't know any better, or do you know better, but there's never really been a person of color around to check you for some of these remarks? What do you think, since you've been kind of immersed in this space where you are the only?
Yeah, you know, I'm not entirely sure, Tiffany, where it comes from. But what I do know is I, you know, just listening to that incredible conversation, right, that you just had with Nicole and Ta-Nehisi, I also consider myself a black woman with extreme position and privilege, right? And when Bravo came to me with the incredible opportunity to be the very first black woman to represent the dynamic, beautiful, brilliant women that are black women in New York City— what a gift, right? What an honor. And I have a responsibility to do that justice and do it in a way that is not singular, because we know there is no singular black female experience, but one that honors the complexity and the dynamic nature of who we are as a culture. So Harlem Night was all about that. As for the women's pushback and resistance to what was being presented, which was a beautiful, I feel like, night of curated black excellence, where I gifted each woman a Harlem candle, shout out to Harlem Candle Company, that was indicative of things I represented in their personality. So they got James Baldwin, they got Billie Holiday, they got Langston Hughes, and they got all of these great lessons of the Harlem Renaissance. Tiffany, what I know for sure is that blackness in America is one of the most misunderstood, underappreciated aspects of American culture. And as somebody in my position who, going back to Nicole and everything she represents that's so important in this moment, I am also an alumnus of UNC Chapel Hill. I got my degree in black studies from UNC Chapel Hill. So I see the attack on an understanding of truthful black American experiences that is going on in our country. And we have to call a thing, Tiffany. And you know I have no problem doing that.
I feel it
is my benevolent, right. It is my benevolent responsibility to use this incredible platform that is global, right? At Real Housewives of New York, global platform, to show up in black excellence, call a thing, and make sure that everybody, including other black Americans, Tiffany, have as best and most appreciated understanding of blackness as I've been blessed to do.
So, you're making the point that you are not necessarily trying to educate the women on the show, but society at large.
Indeed. Listen, it's not my job. You'll see in this week's episode, we air at 9 p.m. Tuesday nights on Bravo. I have a line where I say, I'm not Toni Morrison in this piece, right? And I'm saying it jokingly, but I'm saying it from a place of, I have many jobs. I'm blessed to do many things. One of them that I don't do that I get paid for is educating white Americans on the nature of Black America or white or America in general. So that's not my job. But to have a platform like this, Tiffany, and fail to use it to spread the good news of what it is to be Black in America today, I think would be a great tragedy. I think would be irresponsible of me as, a woman in this position. My Blackness is my favorite thing about me. And if that bores some people, if that infuriates some people, if that is not of interest to some people, Tiffany, frankly, it's not my problem nor my concern.
Right. Well, just really quickly, because we're out of time, but I just want to ask quickly, a lot of people feel like these reality TV platforms perpetuate negative stereotypes about Black women in particular. Do you ever feel conflicted about being a part of the franchise, even though you yourself are not necessarily perpetuating that stereotype?
So I never feel a conflict, Tiffany, because I actually think reality TV is a fascinating cultural juggernaut that, again, has the ability to impact so many people. Everybody's not watching the news. Everybody's not reading the newspaper or listening to talk radio. So for a lot of people, their understanding of our very nation and culture comes from these shows. So to be able to extend my work as an attorney and journalist into this space and have people, Tiff, we talked about this yesterday, from Germany, from Australia, from South Africa, picking up their first copy of James Baldwin's Fire next time, that's a gift, and it tells me it's a job well done.
Well, I want to say you look beautiful on the show, and I was so happy to see you there, and I'm happy to see you spreading some education there. So thank you so much, Ebony, for joining us.